Good morning, Manmohan present here. First of all, I would like to offer my sincere thanks to the Chancellor of this university and Chairman of this national and international conference. My presentation topic is India's contribution in development of economic and social Asian countries. It is rightly said that arguing against the globalization is like arguing against the law of gravity. It is as natural as the law of gravity. So we cannot stop globalization. So what we can do is we can change ourselves according to the wave of globalization. One of the most popular thinker in India says that in Sanskrit, Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karvavahe. It means come, let us sit together, let us eat together, and let us work together for the development of ourselves. So, we can see proliferation of regional organizations appears to be one of the significant trends in post-World War II. Besides the geographical, economic and neo-colonial limitations and inability to cope up with the increasingly complex power politics at the global level and difficulties involved in dealing with the regional problem politics compelled smaller countries to come together and form organizations like ASEAN. In Europe, we have a European Union. We have also SAARC in the Asia and the ASEAN. So, the ASEAN, let me tell a small history about ASEAN. In case of Southeast Asia, the Association of Southeast Asia, or ASA, comprising Malaysia, Philippines, Thailand, it was set up in 1961, but because of some reasons, it could not materialize till 1967. So, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN, ASEAN, it was established on 8 August 1967 in Bangkok with the 5 original members, namely Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Singapore and Thailand. The basic objective was to accelerate economic growth, social progress and cultural development in the region, and to promote the regional peace and stability through undying respect for the justice and rule of law, the relationship among countries, the region, and adherence to the principles of the United Nations. You can see the map of Asian countries. Now it has 10 members. Let us have a look at the map. It shows the income classification. The pink color shows high income countries, the yellow color shows the low income countries, and this green color is for medium lower income countries. So the Asian countries including India and China are in upper middle income or lower middle income countries. Then we can have a map of population, urban population. This dark color shows the population above 80% urban population, and this faint color shows the population below 50% or say 10 to 20% also. Now this is a very important index, Human Development Index. This dark color shows Human Development Index above 0.8, and this faint color shows the Human Development Index between 0.5 to 0.6. Human Development Index consists of three index. One is life expectancy ratio, second one is education index, and third is income index. These three index contribute to human development index. So, what can be done to improve the human development index? We can have better educational opportunities, we can have better healthcare opportunities, and definitely we can have income opportunities. And by improving our economic condition, improving our cultural and health science, we can improve this human development index. So, the ASEAN objective is, the main objective is to develop the human development index. We can have a look at the aim and purpose of ASEAN over here, to accelerate the economic growth, social progress and cultural development in the region, to promote the regional peace and stability, to collaborate more effectively for the greater utilization of their agriculture and industry resources. No organization can work without the fundamental principles, as ASEAN have these fundamental principles. So, coming to the India's contribution, I have divided it into four groups. First one is ASEAN-Indian dialogue relationship. Second is ASEAN-India free trade area. Then we have some agreements and declarations. And we have some statistics of ASEAN-India trade. So, ASEAN-India dialogue relationship. What is this dialogue relationship? ASEAN-India dialogue relations have grown rapidly from a sectoral dialogue partnership in 1992 to a full dialogue partnership in December 1995. The relationship was further rewarded with the convening of the ASEAN-India summit in 2002. Since then, the ASEAN-India summit has been held annually. All this took place in a decade, which clearly signifies the importance of the dialogue partnership with ASEAN and India and the progress of the cooperation. And cooperation in the field of political, the field of socio-cultural cooperation, and definitely the economic cooperation. The one very major milestone in ASEAN-India relationship is the ASEAN-India Commemorative Summit. It was held on the 20th and 21st of December in 2012, in which we have committed to the ASEAN countries that India will contribute, exert efforts and cooperate, effectively implement the plan of action to implement ASEAN-India Partnership of Peace, Progress and Shared Prosperity. This plan was for 2010 to 2015. Then, India will support and cooperate closely with the ASEAN to realize the ASEAN community in 2015, comprising three pillars, namely the ASEAN Political Security Community, the ASEAN Economic Community, and ASEAN socio-cultural community. For the strengthen this cooperation, we agreed to establish ASEAN India Center using existing capacities. The most important economic contribution in the economic cooperation, the constraint of economic globalization and regional integration, we are committed to our efforts in advancing economic cooperation and engaging the emerging regional economic architecture, including organizing multi-sectorial strategic economic dialogues. Then definitely we are committed to reaching greater trade volumes through our FTA, that is a free trade area, realizing our trade and economic potential under our strategic partnership by expanding trade facilitation initiatives. We are therefore committed to achieving a target of $100 billion for ASEAN-India trade by 2015. We are committed to realizing the ASEAN-India free trade area with a combined market of almost 1.8 billion people and combined GDP of $3.8 trillion. In this regard, we welcome the successful conclusion of the negotiation on ASEAN-India trade in service and investment agreements. We are committed to promoting private sector engagement and encouraging business-to-business relations, including through establishing necessary frameworks, strengthening private sector engagement and public-private partnership. Recognizing the important role of small and medium enterprises, that is SMEs, in the region, we are also committed to encouraging collaboration of SME sector. Then, the socio-cultural cooperation. In socio-cultural cooperation, India will strengthen socio-cultural cooperation and promote greater people-to-people interaction through increasing exchanges in culture, education, youth, sports, creative industries, science and technology, information and communication technology. Although the software, human resource development and scholarly exchanges. India will encourage study, documentation and dissemination of knowledge about civilization life between ASEAN and India. India is committed to working together to overcome challenges such as climate change, energy security, rapid urbanization, natural disaster, food security and drug abuse through both regional cooperation and participation in relevant global initiatives. Coming to the free trade area, ASEAN-India free trade area is a free trade area among 10 member states of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations and India. The initial framework agreement was signed on 8 October 2003 in Indonesia, and the final agreement was 13 August 2009. The free trade area came into effect 1 January of 2010. There are various tariffs cut in this free trade area. ASEAN countries and India is having trade between the countries with having very less trades. These are some agreements and declarations. And coming to the statistics, in 2006-07, we have $30 billion trade, including import and export. In 2007-08, we had $39.08 billion. And in 2009-10, we have 12.80 export and 18.09 imports till April to the December of 2009. While coming to Indian contribution, we can say that various events, organizations like seminars contribute a lot in these relations. So let me mark few events. A business and IT seminar was organized by Consulate General of India. Then India's training cell ship INS Sudarshini was welcomed at Bangkok Port on 18 January 2013. Then the Indian Asia Delhi Dialogue was an annual international conference of political and economic leaders, officials, academicians and opinion makers of Asian countries. Then the 15th Asian India Senior Officials Meeting, AISOM, was held in New Delhi in February 12. 2013. So these like events are very important to have a collaboration or coordination and to improve it. So coming to the conclusion, India being the largest democracy in the South, having a vision to have a friendship relations with the Eastern countries, Indian foreign policy has always given emphasis on the relationship of Eastern countries, that is India's look east policy. We have many plans, we have many things to do, but still various things have been untouched, they have remained. So thus India has been making continuous efforts to bring nearer continent through several exchanges for which India looks forward to achieve the expected goals. Thank you very much.